Well, hi there, pluckers. I've Sawfinger again with you. Thanks indeed for joining me for a bit of a fun lesson. This is very light-hearted. Don't take this one too seriously. Okay, this is from 1966, and it's Nancy Sinatra's song, These Boots Are Made for Walking. A bit of a fun lesson. Okay, here we go then. Standard tuning, no capos, as you can see, and I'm doing it in the same key as the original Nancy Sinatra recording. Here we go. Saying you got something for me, something you call love, but confess, you've been messing where you should be messing. You got something else for your best. There's boots on me for walking, not for just living. These days these boots are gonna walk all over you. You keep lying where you ought to be truthful. You keep losing when you ought to not bet. That's right, it's right, the range is right yet. These boots are made of walking, and not for just loving. One of these days these boots are gonna walk all over you. Playing and singing this, it's not my forte, I'm afraid. You get the idea there, don't you? Okay, right. So basically, it's very simple chords. It starts off with the iconic rundown on the old bass, so basically I'm starting it on the, this is for single guitar, obviously, if you've got a bass player handy. Starting on the second fret of the E chord, and I'm playing the second on the fourth there. I'm just going first on the fourth, open fourth, fourth on the fifth, third on the fifth, second on the fifth, first on the fifth, first open fifth, and then into an E chord. Okay, so that's into an E strum. Okay, and it starts off with a sort of, so it's bum bum ba bum, so you've got that first finger hammering in occasionally. Okay, so got that. Okay, so then it goes into the song. Okay, you keep saying you got something for me, something you call love, but confess. Into an A chord. You've been messing where you should be messing. Back to E. Da 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 da. Right, G. These boots are the E. Walking. G. Where's the E? G. To stop. E. And then rock all over, bass run. E. basically it. Okay, just repeats three verses and three choruses, basically. The only slight difference is in the last verse, there is some brass figures, and it's during the verse, and it's like, and it's like, and that's basically just E7th to E6, and back again with pinky, going from the 3rd fret of the 2nd, 2nd fret of the 2nd, back to the 3rd fret of the 2nd. So it's a you keep playing, they shouldn't be playing. Got that? And then we go to an A chord, and to get the same effect I'm playing a lazy A, barring the first 4 strings of the 2nd fret. And I'm playing that da 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 with the A seventh shape, 3rd fret of the 1st string. So that's all it is. It's just that E seventh to 6th, back to 7th, and then you change to the A chord, and you just add that 7th chord. 3rd fret, 1st string. Okay, just adds a bit if you want to. Don't have to do that, but it's on the record, you know. And then the chorus is basically goes to G. And what I like to do is go to the G, where it goes, these boots are made. And I take the bar off and slide it the E back down. To E, the E shape back down to E, and you get that murr sound, which is quite nice. And then on the way up, try and put the, as soon as you come past the 1st fret, put the bar on, and try and get a bit of slide going up as well. So it's a. Okay, that sort of thing. That's the only thing you can add, just to give it a bit more interest. Okay, well, that's it. Very simple lesson. Hope you make some sense out of that and enjoy that. That's some sort of 60s party or other. I'll see you in the next video.